users are there, just some random number. So all the users need to accept that, yes, this is the correct valid block and the hashing algorithm is correct. Whatever the transaction is added is valid. Now the block can be added, right? So that yes should come from the majority of the people. Then only the block will be added to the blockchain. That is called as consensus. So without consensus mechanism, even if you take a public or private or permissionless or permissioned blockchain, right, the blockchain mechanism will not work, number one. So number two, we all know, right, there is something called what is a protocol. Protocol is a generally accepted rules or procedures, right? So we combine this concept and we call it as a consensus protocol. So in the consensus protocol, right, it is agreed by the opinion of all the peoples are here, and as well as we have a certain set of protocol to be agreed by all the party. Will you go for a consensus for each and everything? The answer is no. The rules are concerned, right? For a Bitcoin, there are set of rule, all right? And Ethereum, there are set of rule. But if you go for a Kcash that professor was talking, it has its own set of rule. If you go for a Ripple, it has its own set of rule. Like this, each and every blockchain type, each and every cryptocurrency has its own types of rule. That is called as protocol. So we have a consensus mechanism, right? Voting mechanism as well as the rule protocol being used in the blockchain. So why we use the consensus mechanism and what will happen if you are not using it, right? So the thing is, as you know, right, we discuss about the hashing. We discuss about hashing, right? And we also discuss about the mining process, right? We need to create a hash which should be lesser than the already agreed hash value, right?